While the Sony RX10iv lacks a built-in intervalometer for shooting time-lapse images, you can download their free applications to shoot with the camera tethered to a computer for time-lapse image sequences. The Imaging Edge application is available for both Windows 64-bit and Mac computers and has a viewer, remote control, and editor. I'll be using the Windows version of the Imaging Edge app for some sequences in this video. However, there are alternatives to the Sony apps, and I'll be using some of those too. I'll set up the camera for remote control first. If you have been using your smartphone to control the camera, you must turn off Control with Smartphone on the Network 1 menu, Screen 1 of 2. Then go to Screen 3 of 6 and set the USB setting to PC Remote. While on this menu, you could go to Screen 4 of 6 and set PC Remote settings. I'll use Still Image, Save Destination to PC plus Camera, so I get the image on both the computer and on the SD card in the camera. For this exercise, I'll be just recording JPEG images, but you could save both JPEG and RAW if the camera is set for recording both. To shoot time-lapse sequences, connect the camera to the computer using the USB ports. I use a 90-degree micro USB cable to attach to the camera. I also made a strain relief insert for my tripod head, the blue thing, so the cable is less likely to get yanked around on the camera when shooting long sequences. This reduces the chance of damaging the micro USB connection on the camera. The 90-degree cable is short, so I use a fairly long cable to attach it to the computer. When you plug the camera into the computer, you will see the connection screen on the camera. Run the app on your computer. I'm using the Imaging Edge app, and select the DSC RX10 M4 camera by double-clicking. You may see other devices in the list, but they cannot be used with the software. When the app and the camera are connected, the camera returns to the normal display on its monitor. If using the Imaging Edge app, you will be open to the program and see a live view from the camera, along with the control panel for changing some camera settings. You can toggle the live view off and on as desired. Some things can only be changed from the camera, but changes are reflected in the app. For example, changing to shutter priority from manual is reflected on the computer display. Changing to autofocus single is also reflected in the computer display. I'll return to manual settings for time lapse. Using auto settings results in more flicker in the final video as light changes. I'll also set white balance to daylight so it remains constant. Since this will be a video, I have also turned off DR, set ISO to 100, aspect to 16:9, file format to JPEG, quality to X-Spine, drive mode to single. Focus, shutter speed, and aperture will be set when I'm ready to shoot. You can also set the prefix for images saved on the computer and the folder to which they will be saved. To set the interval, click on the interval icon. You can start capturing immediately after clicking start, or you can set a delay. Your capture interval can be set from 10 seconds to 180 minutes. For some things, 10 seconds is a little long, and I'll show you how that can be reduced, although not with this app. I'll use 10 seconds and set the number of images to capture at 300. This will provide a 10-second video when making a 30 frames per second video. This video of clouds forming, moving, and dissipating was formed from the 300 images shot with the Sony software. I'm going to use a VMware Player virtual machine on the same computer I used to shoot the previous time-lapse, and just a few minutes after the previous shooting finished. The virtual machine has the Linux operating system Xubuntu installed. The software that will drive the camera is GPhoto 2. All are available free on the internet. The graphical user interface for Xubuntu functions similar to Windows. However, I'll issue commands from a command window. Windows has the same kind of capability, but it is not often used today and can't be used for this application. First, I need to allow the virtual machine to control a camera. I do this from the Player menu. I select Removable Devices and select the camera and allow the virtual machine to assume control of the camera. Since I will be downloading the images to the computer, I want to make a folder for the images. This is done just as with Windows. Right-click and select Create Folder. Give the folder a name and double-click it to open it. Then I click in the folder and open the command window. I right-click the mouse and open Terminal here. This sets the folder as the default destination for output from the next commands. Once the terminal window is open, I can type commands into the window. I only need two commands to do the time lapse. Just about everything that you could do with the Sony software can be done using GPhoto 2, but it is less convenient. The two commands I need to enter are GPhoto 2, Auto Detect. This tells the software to determine if the camera is attached and what camera it is. The second command, GPhoto 2, Capture Image and Download, and Keep, I5 F300. This command tells the program to capture images and download to the computer, keep them on the camera, and use an interval of 5 seconds, and to capture 300 frames. Once I press the Enter key, the command begins execution. The computer will direct the camera to continue to shoot images until all are shot. This video was produced from the time-lapse images shot by GPhoto 2. Since the interval was shorter, the clouds moved smoother and more slowly. While these time-lapse videos were shot using my Toshiba laptop, I also use an old Gateway netbook on which I replaced Windows Vista with Linux Xubuntu. It works great and is much smaller than my regular laptop. If you are adventurous, even the Raspberry Pi computer can be used to control the camera, although not as conveniently as the other options. Here are more examples of time-lapse videos shot with the Sony RX10iv. If you enjoyed this video or found it useful, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for viewing.